In the previous series of videos, we implemented reactive form with input text element, select element, radio button and checkbox. In this video, we will see how to implement form submission in reactive form. I have already implemented the coding required for form submission. Let me walk through the changes implemented. In app.component.html, we already know that the form group defined here is a directive. If we look into the documentation of this directive in the properties section, we can see the ng-submit event emitter defined, which is what I have included in the form tag. This definition helps to track the form submission event. If we look into the template-driven form implementation, there as well we used ng-submit. This ng-submit belongs to the ng-form directive, whereas the ng-submit defined now refers to the form group directive. The ng-submit event is made to point to submit function. The signup form template reference variable is passed as parameter in the submit function call, which passes the object of form group directive. Now we will look into the submit function defined in the component class. We can see the function parameter data type is form group directive. Similar to template driven form implementation, the form validity is checked using the valid property available in form group directive, and the form data is printed in the console. This is what is the coding required to implement form submission. Now we can check how it works in the page. I have already entered some data in the form. I have a validation error on the name input text element. Now I am clicking on the submit button. Due to the existence of validation error, the form data is not displayed in the browser console. Now I am correcting the validation error. If I submit the form now, we can see the form data printed as JSON in the browser console. This clearly demonstrates that the form is submitted only when all the form fields are valid, and we are able to obtain the form data using the value property, which can be sent to the backend for further processing. In the submit function of app.component.ts, I have included a comment wherein we can include the code to make the backend call. With this, we have successfully implemented form submission handling in a reactive form. Let me summarize the changes to be done. In app.component.html, include the ng-submit event pointing to the submit function. In app.component.ts, include submit function as specified here. Save both the files and check if form submission works as demonstrated.